All right, you ready?
Oh, we're rolling. Okay, good. All right. Hey, everybody. Squirrels Tonight. This is Jim and Brian.
And we are professionals.
Tonight we have a very special guest on.
Who is it, Brian? Who is it?
My daddy, Mr. Royce Fields.
Glad to have you with us tonight, Mr. Fool.
Sink up in this chair.
How you doing tonight, Daddy?
I'm doing fine. How y'all?
Yeah, do I need to call you Daddy or Mr. Fields?
I think Mr. Fields would be nicer.
Okay.
Can I call you Daddy then?
I got around, but not that far.
Well, I forgot what I was going to say. If laughter is the best medicine, who died from laughing? That's my first question.
You stumped me.
Never mind. Okay. How long were you at the Jefferson County Sheriff's Department?
32 years. Well, 31 years, 9 months, 20 days.
Okay. 20 days. We're not going to get into anything in specific with the Sheriff's Department, but we're not going to get into anything in specific. But you had some questions about some stuff, didn't you?
Well, I imagine in that career, in that span of time, you probably saw some incredible leaps in technology that y'all used. I mean, what did you have when you first started, like a CB and a gun, basically?
Our radios were not good as CBs. you had coverage. You had coverage probably from... Well, we had fair coverage around Oak Grove, say where Oak Grove School's at, across Toadvine and across to Birmingham. But if you got on anywhere below there toward the river, toward Warrior River, no coverage whatsoever. Anywhere in anywhere down Mud Creek Road from... Well, most everybody that's going to be watching this will know where Bo Fields lived, but after you go by Bo Fields' house and get behind that mountain...
He used to be dead.
You won't hear anything else till you get over to Adger, to the mines at number 3.
You must have had AT&T. You must have had AT&T.
We had Motorola's, but they didn't have very good antennas.
And right before you retired, everything pretty much was going or had gone digital.
It had already gone. We'd already gone digital for probably 12 years.
When did you get your first bulletproof vest?
Got my first bulletproof vest in 1986.
Okay. I thought it was back then. Now they're real light and thin and back then it was, several different parts and heavy.
Mine was all in one part, but it weighed about 25 pounds.
Make it look like RoboCop with it on.
He didn't wear it. I did. I used to wear it and play with it out in the front yard.
Yeah, but you were pretending it was like a Star Trooper suit or something like
Star Wars, get it right.
Star Wars.
Yeah, Luke Skywalker.
Star Wars stuff.
With Jefferson County going bankrupt, what do you think about Oak Grove incorporating? You think it needs to incorporate and start generating its own revenue?
I don't see where it could help itself any incorporating other than it can't help itself with the fire department. It can't help itself any with law enforcement. might help itself with garbage.
Yeah, we were talking about that last week with Aunt Claudette.
I'm for the incorporation, but I don't think that Oak Grove can incorporate unless it's the whole Concord Fire District. It would have to incorporate completely.
Just do the fire district.
Do what?
I don't think it has a tax base to, as far as retail. I know there's enough people down there. As far as retail, there's nothing.
It does not have the tax base for.
Mr. Fields, is it true that the character Buford T. Justice was based on you?
I hope not.
Well, that's what I had been told.
I'm sure that there's quite a few people that would have liked to have thought that whenever I was. They would have looked at the Dukes and said that I was Buford T.
Hey,
No, not the Dukes. It was a truck.
He's talking about walking tall, right? You're talking Smoking about.
Oh, yeah. You thought I was talking about.
Boss
Hall.
I'm the retarded
Custer.
Son that goes, Daddy, he got away from the
kid. Is that who you were talking about?
No, I was talking about
Junior.
Oh, yeah, Smokey and the Bandit.
Smokey and the Bandit, right.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But now I can't.
What was his name?
Buford T. Justice.
But no, I mean Walking Tall Guy.
Buford Pusser. Pulaski County, Tennessee.
Okay. All right.
Didn't you ever watch it?
Yeah, I did.
The Rock softly carried a big stick.
The Rock did a good job with it, I thought.
Oh, that was the crappiest remake ever.
It was.
That's a true story. I mean, we don't need some Miami football player punk coming in trying to beat Buford Pusser. Didn't work. Do away with it.
Okay. I watched the beginning and got lost in it. Let's see. What's your favorite way to relax?
My recliner. Watching any kind of sports. Basketball, football, baseball, softball. Girl, I love Alabama softball.
And who's your number one team in college?
Oh, Alabama, whoever.
Okay.
I hear you. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Can you tell one quick story, though, without – you ain't got to get too detailed on it or anything, but there was this one time – you were talking about radios a while ago going bad. There was this one time you were coming out of Adger, I believe it was, and y'all had a bunch of burglaries down here, and you saw some guys fitting that description. I think you were in your own car. You wasn't even in a patrol car, and you managed to pull these dudes over, and you got kind of stuck with them at gunpoint. Is that right?
I was coming. I had got off work. I was working day shift. And I had got off at 2 o'clock and was headed home down 15th Street.
Okay.
And when I got to where CC Camp Road, where that new, I believe it's Calvary Church is now, but it wasn't there then.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place.
I approached the CC Kemp Road on 15th Street. I saw a large black male run across 15th Street.
Yeah.
And was running to a car parked on CC Kemp Road off to the right.
Yeah.
I recognized the black male as Willie Glover.
Okay.
A ex-inmate at the Jefferson County Jail.
Okay.
He...
So you knew him beforehand?
Sure, I knew him, and with him running across from the other car up to that 56 Chevrolet that he was driving, I didn't know what they had burglarized or robbed the store down there at Payne's Grocery.
Okay.
So I took on off and went on down to Payne's, and there was a lady in, out in front of Payne's. When I pulled in, she flagged and said that there was three black males that had just burglarized their home down on Taylor's Ferry Road. And that they had followed them there, and they were trying to call the sheriff's department. Her neighbor, the lady that they had burglarized, was inside Payne's calling the sheriff's department. I told her to tell her neighbor that I was turning around and going back after them, and that to get to let her neighbor tell the sheriff's department to get somebody out there and help me. Well, if everybody knows where Lake Creek is, that's a big dip on 15th Street Road before you go up to Roper's Horse Farm. And as I went down, started down the hill, Lake Creek, I saw the two cars. I saw the Chrysler that two of the black males were in, and I saw the Chevrolet that Willie Glover was driving. Willie was out with the back doors on the Chrysler open, fixing to drag some stuff out. And I wheeled in behind and, you know, popped my door open and got out, put my gun on them. And Willie saw me pulling in and sliding up, so he run back around and got in his Chevrolet and
took off.
Was burning, throwing gravel all over me. Dust, but the other two knew that they were in trouble, and that I was gonna. I had my pistol on them. Are we running out of time?
We're getting close, but go ahead.
I had my pistol on them. Anyhow, I got them out of the car. I got out of my car and got made each one of them stick their hand out the door and open the door and get out and come. Made the driver come back first. I made him get down on the ground, back up to me, lay on the ground, spread out with a hand over his head and feet wide open, and then made the passenger do the same thing.
Well, so you had him at gunpoint, and then what'd you do? You had him laid out at gunpoint. Did you have to wait on somebody?
I had been there about 35, 40 minutes with cars zooming back and forth past. Couldn't get anybody to stop, help, whatever. Finally, my brother-in-law came down the road from Virginia Mines that worked for the Water Works, Quarry River Water, and Don Reed. And he stopped. He was the only one that I could get stopped. And he helped me. I think, best I remember, I let him take my pistol and I handcuffed him. I didn't even have them handcuffed all that time. I just stand there with a pistol on them.
Did you have to yell at them the whole time, keep them down? Or
no, sir. Know? They knew not to move. I knew both of them, Lewis and Big Red, so they wasn't going anywhere.
Pig Lewis and Big Red.
Yeah. I knew both of them from jail, too.
Okay.
So they weren't. This wasn't first-timers?
Oh, no. No, they were old-time burglars, all three of them. And, at any rate, I got Don. He had a radio, and it was Warrior River Water radio, and I got him going and radio after I got him handcuffed, going up to the top of the hill. And I don't think he could get out down there at Lick Creek, but he went on up the top of the hill, and I think he was able to. I can't remember whether he had a radio or a bag phone. He may have had a bag phone.
Okay.
But at any rate, he was able to call the sheriff's department. But I didn't get anybody out there. Now, all this was going on about 3:30. And I finally got help out there at 5.
Five o'clock. We just ran out.
No, we keep going. Is that okay? We're about done? Okay. All right. Well, thank you for coming on.